You know what's behind my head? It's a chart that if you use it the way I tell you to, you're going to make more money and you're going to find more happiness in 2022 and the rest of your life. Let's jump into it. Lean in here. Lean in here. I got something to tell you. You chose to be exactly where you are right now. You chose that. I know it pisses a lot of people off when I say that to them, but listen, don't let it upset you. I want it to upset you, but I want you to understand something. If you take complete ownership of your life, you can do something about it. If I'm where I'm at because something out of my control put me here, I can't fix that. It's out of my control. But if I take complete ownership of it, then I can do something about it. If I put myself in this situation, I can get myself out. If somebody else put me into this, then I'm at their mercy to get me out. I used to start presentations that way when I spoke in jails and juvenile detention centers. And I'd say, man, I can't believe you guys chose to be here. And I would, you know, lightheartedly, it was upsetting to them, but I wanted them to be mad. Because sometimes you got to get angry enough to want to change. But I'd say, yeah, last night, you know, I woke up in the middle of the night and I walked to the fridge and I opened it up and I grabbed the milk jug and I drank right out of it. And then I went and used the bathroom all by myself with nobody else looking at me or seeing me, and had some really soft toilet paper. And then I went and turned on the TV and watched what I watched. And I wanted them to feel the pain of what they were missing out on, because they literally made decisions. There's always exceptions to the rule of everything I say. But they literally made decisions that cost them their freedom and to be in jail. So they chose that. And I chose not to do those things at that certain point in my life and was on the outside and was on free. So I was trying to get them to understand that. So as upsetting as it was to them, and as upsetting it is for you to hear, I really want you to grasp that. You got to have complete ownership. Let's dive into this a little deeper, right? Why is it that we end up in the same type of jobs, we end up in the same type of relationships, we end up making the same type of money? Or let's even say that we were making $20,000 a year, and then we went to $30,000 a year, and then we went to $40,000 a year, but we're still living check to check. Is it really just because we don't know how to save? Is it really because we're keeping up with the Joneses? Is it really because we just don't have any discipline? Does that make sense to anybody? Well, of course it does, if you understand the nature of our psychology and our habits and our subconscious. And what it is we are on a regulator, so to speak, right? Think of it like an air conditioner or an autopilot. And you may have heard of these analogies before, but it's worth reviewing real quick. Like a thermostat in your home, right? If you set it at 70 and it gets too hot, then the air kicks on and brings it back down to 70. If it gets too cold, then the heat kicks on and gets it back up to 70. It keeps you right where you're at. Same with autopilot. You get a little off track, it puts you back on course. A little off track, it puts you back on course. Your subconscious and your belief system create thoughts and feelings that act like a regulator, that act like an autopilot. So if you start making too much money and you have the thoughts that you can't save and you're not worthy of wealth and all these other thoughts, then it'll create an atmosphere where you're spending again, so you get even killed. It's in survival mode. I want to dig a little deeper into this, because a lot of times you read books on it and you don't know what actions to take. And there's a lot of different things you can do, but this is one thing that I've been training some of my guys on here recently, and I work on myself on constantly, that I think would be of really high value to you. And it's just one way to look at it, but to know thyself, right? That's the biggest thing, is you got to really get into what's down in that programming, what's down in that software running behind everything, what's in the subconscious. Year after year, I uncover things in my life that I didn't even know were in my subconscious. And we're keeping me on certain paths that I've been trying to get off of. So how do you dig into that and get to understand it? I think this will be really powerful, this chart I'm about to show you, and how you can utilize it. But you got to spend some time and some really deep thought and journaling and knowing yourself going through this process. But if you do it, you're going to be amazed at the changes you can make in your relationships, at work, and your income. You really can apply this to any area of your life. Let's get into it. All right, so now that I got my big noggin out of the way. So here's the diagram I want you to have and I want you to use. And this is kind of a little bit high level stuff. There's different ways you can develop your self-awareness and get in this, but this is one that I really like and have been, again, I've been using here recently. And the first thing is that your beliefs, okay? Your beliefs are nothing but decisions. They are decisions that you've made. Now, you've made those decisions based off experiences you've had and knowledge that you've obtained. That's how we come to our decisions or our beliefs. So there's a lot of people right now that think that taking a certain injection, you got to be careful with the words you use. I don't want to get banned on YouTube, is a great idea. And there's others who think it's a horrible idea. And they are, neither one is necessarily right or wrong. I don't think we know at this point. I know it's going to upset some of you. But each of them truly believe they are right. It depends on the experiences you've had and the information that you have and who you listen to and who you trust and who you have confidence in. But it's their belief, their wholehearted belief, right? That's all a belief is, a decision that we've made depending on experiences and knowledge that we have. So that's why knowledge is so important. One of the first videos I made just a couple weeks ago on this kind of series, if you will, was about becoming an internal student. You got to ever be learning. Why? Because your knowledge is what helps you grow and change and become something else, become a better version of yourself. And if you're not growing, then you're stuck where you are, right? You're stalemate, you're lukewarm, and you're falling behind, actually. If we could get into that at a whole nother topic. But and also, it's important why people like to travel, because those experiences and knowledge create different beliefs than them, opens up the world to them. That's why people read, that's why people get new friends, that's why they try new experiences, that's why they travel. So you should really challenge yourself to constantly be trying new things and challenge your beliefs. Don't get stuck in old habits or in old routines. You should always be growing and developing, always. All of life was put here meant to grow and to develop, just like a plant just strives towards the sun. The universe is ever expanding. You should always be growing towards the sun. You should always be ever expanding. If you're not happy and you're not producing what you want in your life, that's part of the problem, is you've stopped expanding. There is no standing still. You're either moving forward or you're actually getting left behind. And so that's a big cause of it. But belief, that's a whole nother topic, but beliefs become thoughts. Whatever decision we've made, we now have a thought about that belief. That thought creates feelings, emotions in us. We feel a certain way about that. Those feelings and emotions produce actions. Those actions bear fruit. They are our results. Those results confirm our beliefs, okay? This is the cycle. So let me give you a quick example of how this might work for somebody. Let's say that you had a bad experience as a child with dogs. And you think that all dogs are vicious and mean, even small dogs, and they don't like you personally. And so you just stay away from dogs. And so what happens is one day you're out and you and two friends, you're walking down the street and here comes a dog off the leash, turns the corner, it's coming right towards you. It's big enough that it sends you into panic mode, right? Because you believe dogs are vicious and mean and don't like you. So you start thinking, oh my gosh, there's a dog. It's vicious. It's going to attack me. It doesn't like me. Here it comes. And you start getting all nervous and you're putting out this energy into the world. And the dog can sense the nervousness and the fear and anxiety in you. And the dog's like, you know, I just has natural instinct, but why is this person scared? Why is this person upset? They must have did something wrong. And then you start feeling terrified. And you start feeling overwhelmed and anxious. And so what do? You run. You go running looking for somewhere safe because you want to escape the terror that you're feeling. You don't want to get attacked or bit. And so you take action. And what does that action do? It produces a fruit. That fruit is the dog sees your nervousness, your tension, sees you take off running, or you raise your hands, which you shouldn't do with a dog, and you don't know the rules because you don't have the experience. And the dog comes after you, runs right between your two friends and chases you and bites you on the leg. And then you turn around and you say, see, dogs are vicious and they don't like me. It ran right past you two just to attack me. So you caused that. We go back to the beginning and you're not even aware that you caused that. Let's think a little bit more, maybe financially. Let's talk about this. So you think you're only worth $30,000 a year, and that is your belief. And so you're sending out job things, and your thoughts are, you know, you're putting in Indeed, you know, for a certain type of job, and you're capping the salary at 30, 35, because you don't feel worthy. You don't feel worthy or experienced enough anybody's going to give you a $40,000 a year job. So your actions are setting that limit. And indeed, of only looking for jobs that are entry level or only pay up to $30,000 or $35,000, you can't believe anybody would give you $10,000 more than what you used to be you're used to making, or maybe $50,000. And so what are the results? Well, the results, nobody that's paying $40,000 contacts you or reach out, and you stay stuck in that position, right? And you could do that with any number, wherever you're at, $50,000, $70,000, $100,000. You don't believe somebody's going to pay you more, and you don't feel worthy of it, so you don't take the action to do it, and that produces the same results. The other flip side of that is, if you believe that you're worth $100,000 a year, and you're like, let me think about this. Why are they only paying me 50 or 60? That kind of frustrates me and angers me and challenges me. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to prove to them I'm worth that. And if they don't want to pay me, somebody else will. So I start taking the actions to demonstrate to my employer or to my customers how valuable I am. And I learn new skills and I apply those skills and I earn money for people. And then what happens, this has happened in my life, then either they give you the promotion or somebody else comes along and snags you up or hires you or takes you from that company. And then it confirms, see, I told you I was worth $100,000. You should have been paying me that. It works in any direction. But here's another cool thing about this. You can start anywhere in the progress if it's easier for you and reverse engineer it. But you got to spend a lot of time on these things to understand what you really believe down in that subconscious. But let's say that you're feeling a certain way. You're feeling always jealous or insecure. Then reverse it. What am I thinking that makes me feel insecure or jealous in this situation? And when you uncover that you're thinking this, then what is my belief that causes me to think that things are this way? Then you got to challenge that belief, right? Then you've got to create a new belief through new knowledge and new experiences, and possibly just get rid of it because it's a disserving belief. Maybe it served you in the past, but maybe it has no value now. Maybe it's something you was raised in, but you need to overcome that and change it because it's not serving you and it's not truth for you anymore and it's causing these issues. Same thing. What are the results I'm getting? I'm only earning this much money, or I keep doing this in relationships. Well, let's look back. What are the actions I have been taking that produce these results? I'm sitting in jail. Why am I in jail again? Well, what actions did you take to get yourself in jail, partner? Okay, those actions were because you were feeling a certain way, that was the only choice you had. You were feeling mad at society. You was feeling that peer pressure, whatever those feelings were. Where did those feelings come from? Because you believed this about yourself. And so you were thinking, you were thinking this about yourself or about the situation. Where did that come from? From the beliefs that's just how life is, or that's the situation I'm in, or that's the life I live, or that's the hand I was dealt. Whatever your belief is, caused this entire situation. So especially if you're feeling stuck or you're feeling unhappy in a certain area, I would go back to this graph. And if you need this graph emailed to you, just screenshot it. Or if you need it emailed, let me know. I'll email it to you. We'll figure out a way to do that. But go back and just look at that and ask yourself, you know, one of these places, what actions am I taking? Why am I constantly drinking? Why am I overeating? Why am I not making enough money? You know, why am I divorced again? Whatever it is, challenge yourself in these areas and you can reverse engineer it. So what's amazing about this is once you find out what that limiting belief is, that thing that's keeping your autopilot locked on, keeping your thermostat set at $40,000 a year, $70,000 a year, or wherever you're stuck, once you figure out what that thermostat setting is, all you gotta do is change it. All you gotta do is create a new belief. So if I wanted to make $100,000 a year, what would I have to believe? If I wanted to make $250,000, $500,000, $1 million a year, what would I have to believe? Then you produce that new belief. And the people who believe that way, what do they think? What do they feel? What actions do they take? And it will produce those results. Does that make sense? Do I need to drill down deeper on any of these parts? Let me know in the comments below if I do, if you found this helpful. Man, I pray this blesses you, and I hope that you're able to utilize this to have the most incredible 2022 and future designed layout for you. And I hope you put in the comments if you uncover some beliefs you didn't even know you had and what you changed the belief to. I want to hear these stories. I want to hear these testimonies. Whatever you do, I'm challenging everybody this year, get off zero. Get your first bit of cryptocurrency. Make your first dollar online. Be blessed.